It's an absolutely beautiful afternoon in Toronto, Ontario. And hockey returns as the Carolina Hurricanes get ready to play the Washington Capitals. And bubble hockey will never be this exciting. You're looking inside Scotiabank Arena in Toronto, Ontario, where an exhibition matchup between the Carolina Hurricanes and Washington Capitals is ready to hit the ice. Hello, everyone. Alongside Trip Tracy, I'm Mike Maniscalco. And Trip, well, let's just say it's been a long 4.5 months where everything has changed.
Well, hello over there, Mike, and your Hurricane Red. And, you know, it's so exciting to be back. And I think about all the time with John Forsman, the privilege with all the great Hurricanes to cover the overtime Stanley Cup playoff moments, Game 7 wins, big goals en route to a Stanley Cup. And I don't want to put too much pressure on you, Big Rig, but I'm asking you come Saturday to create some of those memories that will be etched into my mind moving forward. Hope it's not too much pressure. You're up to it.
Well, the easy thing, Trip, for me is when you've got somebody like Justin Williams, those memories are easily made for Mr. Game 7, and we know he's going to be counted upon here in Toronto.
Well, I looked at his return after his hiatus in the first half of the season in two chapters. The scripted, ultra-scripted, perfect return in front of the home fans, getting a shootout winner against the New York Islanders. But then it took him a while to play vintage Justin Williams hockey. The 5 to 7 games before play was suspended, he did just that. In particular, chemistry with Jordan Staal, which I expect to continue. He was impactful, dangerous, each and every shift.
Well, he was on a 5-game goal scoring streak when we pressed pause. 6 goals in those 5 games. By the way, 38 years old, not that old, but he joins Johnny Pusick and Brett Hull as the oldest guys to do that on a goal scoring streak. But Trip, if we talk about the Carolina Hurricanes, you have to talk about the young guns and someone like Sebastian Aho.
Well, what excites me most about Sebastian when play starts against New York on Saturday? He was an all-star last year, but then he was banged up. One of the top centermen in the league, but a slight frame. He's 100% healthy right now. And I think his position to really play a game of strength and outperform whoever the top center is on any given opponent, starting with New York again on Saturday. You'd never hear him complain about it, but I don't think he was 100% in the playoffs. He is now, had particularly a great goal scoring year this season.
Well, speaking of great goal scorers, we can say that about Andrei Svechnikov.
Well, when I think about the rookie sensation that scored 20, but all its even strength, what has he done this year? He's become a more complete player. He's produced on the power play. None of those goals his rookie year were on the power play, and not one, but 2 lacrosse goals that were gigantic in winning those 2 hockey games against Calgary, Winnipeg, we'll see in a second. But when you're more complete, as Andre has become, you're much tougher to defend against.
Well, the Carolina Hurricanes were counting on Dougie Hamilton, but before the break, he was injured. That's why the Canes traded for Sammy Vatanen. So he slots in with Dougie unfit to play right now. Trip, how does he fit?
Well, we hope to see Dougie soon, a Norris Trophy candidate before he broke his leg. But the deepest defense in the league, in my opinion, Sammy Vatanen, getting used to a new system. Here's a guy that's so efficient, he can log heavy, heavy minutes. He's a righty like Dougie, so he should fit in nicely with Jacob Slavin in Dougie's spot on the power play unit. So this is a big series for Vatanen to be a difference maker.
Well, the team has waited over 4.5 months for this. And coming up, puck drop between the Canes and Caps.